All right, what's going on, everybody? So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you exactly how to use the PropStream app. And this is only going to be about a 10-minute real estate video, so you're definitely going to want to watch all the way to the end of it so you don't miss anything. And that being said, let's jump into it. So the very first thing you're going to want to do is obviously go to the App Store, pull it up here, and type in PropStream. And as you can see, it's right here, and I actually already downloaded it. And if you are already a member of PropStream, it's free to download. And if you're a real estate investor or real estate agent and you're not using PropStream, I'd highly recommend you check it out. I'll put a link below to a free trial. And actually, if you sign up using my link, I'll do a free 30-minute coaching call with you. I'm an affiliate for PropStream, so get a little bit of a cut for each sale, but it's a really awesome service. So I'm gonna go ahead and open the app up. And this is the interface. You can see to start with, you can search by address, APN, as well as geolocation. And we'll go into each of these briefly, but the geolocation part is really cool because you can just be driving around and depending on where you are, it'll have like a little blue circle and you can like exactly locate the property, get contact information, market to them, everything like that. So if you see here on the bottom, you have search, favorites, drive, history, as well as more. To start with, we'll just put in an address. And this was actually a property that I purchased recently. But so when you pull up an address, you know, you can see all this information similar to the desktop version of PropStream. So, you know, 3 beds, 1.5 baths, 2,000 square feet. If the property was ever listed on the MLS, you'll be able to find that data. You'll be able to see the pictures. You can see comps. You know, it'll show you cash buyers in the area, neighbors. You can look at both MLS and public record comps and get a really good idea of different properties in the neighborhood. You can click on opportunity. It's going to kind of show you trends and things like that. It'll show you how much the property could rent out for. That's actually might be a little bit high, but I think the value, the 478, is a pretty good ballpark. Skip trace. So if you wanted to, you know, you find a property, an address, and you wanted to skip trace and contact these people and get their phone number, get their email, get their mailing address, all you have to do is run skip trace. So I would need to actually purchase some credits, but it's a very simple thing to do. And it takes, you know, I think just a few minutes. I've done it before through the desktop version. Postcard, you can mail them a postcard. So we have lots of different options here. And what's really cool about this is you can actually take a photo. So if I click on property picture, I can just take a photo of the property and it'll put it into that black space right there. So it's a very like specific attention grabbing type of postcard. And then you can always change, you know, what you want to say. You know, we'll just keep that in there for now. But, you know, you can just be marketing, you know, if you're driving for dollars or you just come across a property. We have documents. So below we'll see like assessor's map, comparative market analysis. I mean, it goes really into detail on comps and information and data and things like that. Then we also have directions. If you need directions, to the property, there we go. And then lastly, you can share it. So if you have a teammate, you can, or you just want to share it with somebody, you can share the information, you can send it to them. So that's pretty cool. You can also obviously search by APN. Geolocation is pretty interesting. So let's say you're driving around and you come across a property. Let's say you're just driving for dollars, right? And you come across a property. As you can see, these are all condos over here. So let me go to where there's more like single family houses. We'll go over here a little bit. So let's say I'm just driving on 7th Street, as you can see. And let's say I see a house that looks like it needs a lot of work. You can see the grid lines here. And if I click on them, it's going to pull up the information. So I can see that I can pull up the information and I can market to them. So it'll give me tons of information on like the mortgage, assessed values, when it was sold. They got it for $218,000 and now it's worth over $800,000. Not bad. Tax information, transaction history. And then I could obviously skip trace them. You do a lot of different things. So that's a pretty cool feature. Let's go back here. You can also favorite properties. So let's say I wanted to continually market to this property. I could save it like that, or favorite it, I mean. And now it's going to show up in my app, but it's also going to show up on the desktop version. So, you know, throughout the course of a year, you might have like hundreds or thousands of favorited properties that you can market to, reach out to, and chances are if you're diligent about this, you could probably get a couple of deals from it. You can also put tags so you can say, you know, follow up, left a message, not interested, you know, different things like that, sent marketing. And you can say, look, overgrown lawn, and maybe property looks neglected, you know, different things like that, apply, just so you have it in your notes. I'm going to go back to the homepage now and show you another feature. So if you look at the bottom, you can see search, favorites, drive history. So I'm going to click on drive. And this is a pretty cool resource because it can track your drives, or if you have a teammate, it can track their drives. And then you can also set filters on your drive, which is pretty interesting. So you can find properties in your own backyard that might have tax liens, that might be in pre-foreclosure, that might have different things going on with them. So for here, I'd put in 10 miles or 15 miles, whatever you want to do. Owner occupied, I'm just going to keep that at any. Some people will do non-owner occupied, and you could do vacant. I'm going to do a couple other features. You can do property characteristics. For ownership info, I put in 10 years of ownership. And what else did I do? Liens. So I'm doing 10 years of ownership within 10 miles of me or 15 miles of me. And then I also did liens. So you can do different types of liens. You know, you can do all types of liens. I'm just going to do tax liens owned at least 10 years, which probably there would be some equity in there. And within 15 miles of me. So I'm going to press apply. And it's going to pull up all the properties in my area. And the ones in red, obviously, are the properties that have liens. And so you can pull up the different properties if you want, and it'll just give you tons of information. So, and then you can zoom in, and you know, if you're targeting, let's say, a specific neighborhood where maybe you want to purchase a property or invest, you know, you can really zoom in here, click on that. Oh, that's actually a church. That's weird. Oh, I'm clicking on the wrong one. So here, I don't know if this is the right one. There we go. All right, so this has a tax lien on it. Could be a really good property to market to. So you could skip trace them. Opportunity, obviously high value. Comps, you know, it just gives you so much information, detail. And that could be a property, you know, maybe you door knock or maybe you do different things. And you could be, you know, maybe more strategic if you're driving for dollars and you can locate all the properties around a certain area. So that's pretty interesting. History, these are just some of the properties that I've been looking at that I brought up. Favorites. This was, you know, eventually you would have maybe like 100 or maybe 1,000 properties on the favorites list. And then you could start marketing to them in different capacities. I'm going to click on the bottom here. I'm going to click more. That just gives me some more information. Customer support, news updates, account information, help videos, history. So overall, it's a really cool app. I think it's a must have if you're a real estate investor or real estate agent. You're always on the go. You need to pull up information. It gives you so much data and so many different ways to contact people and keep track of different leads. It's a really cool app. And if you haven't signed up for PropStream yet, like I mentioned earlier, I'm going to put a free 7-day trial below. And if you sign up using my link, I'll do a free 30-minute coaching call with you. All you would have to do is basically shoot me an email or reach out to me on Instagram. And we can set up a time for a call. So if you have any questions, drop them in the comment section below, and I'll see you in the next video. All right, bye.